good position.
He was in there like Game of Thrones. He was king of the Seven Kingdoms.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was really good possession, and there's not a lot, again, that Doc Sadler's team can do about that.
No, he's such a long target. He's not a wide target,
right.
But he's a long stretch of highway.
Man, that time he goes right down the baseline and gives it up. No foul called. And one. That's an offensive foul, excuse me. An offensive foul. I saw Lawson come flying in at the very end, and I thought the foul was on him. It was not. It was a charging foul on Watts.
Well, he was clearly outside the arc, and he had a pretty square position, so he nice offensive take there.
Yep.
From our angle, it was hard to see that he was so set and so square.
Cosby. That was halfway down and back out again.
Those shoes of his, you could go jogging in those at night, huh?
Oh, yeah. You could light up a neighborhood.
So we're going to wear trick or treat next year so I don't get ran over. Well, they got the one charge, and so if you're going to get back-to-back charge calls, you know, they call it a 50-50 call a lot. I think it probably sways towards the block more than the charge if you want to talk about percentages. But, you know, it's tough to get them back-to-back unless you just absolutely got the goods on somebody.
That replay we all just saw, they saw it up here on the big screen, and the crowd reacted. They thought that Lawson was set in time.
He was set, but the kid got to his hip, so that's where it turned in. Just, you know, if you're wearing one of these red T-shirts up here, you don't like it, and if you're up in the gold section behind the bench there, you know, you had a different feeling.
Look at you with perspective all of a sudden. Man, you used to see this through jaundiced eyes.
Yeah, I did. Now it's partisan fandom. I'm an independent now.
That was, we don't know. So the ball goes to Western Kentucky. It went off the hands of Ramey.
Western Kentucky's trying to give them a chance to get back at this thing. They've had three or four, you know, runs up and down the floor here where if Southern Miss did the right thing, they'd be sneaking up into single digits.
Mm-hmm. Six turnovers for Southern Miss, five for Western Kentucky.
Their court spacing is such they're trying to isolate the post. You got four out, now Nash sneaks in.
That's where I'd like to see Lawson go in there and set a presence in the paint. He got in the paint, and then he backed out away from the paint.
Well, you'd like to teach a guy to post longer or repost. Not,
repost,
you
right.
Know, what happens to guys that don't get post touches at the end of the night, they go, you know, coach, nobody threw me the ball in the paint. And you go, well, we were only in there for a hiccup. I mean, you got to hang in there for a little longer.
That's right.
And so, you know, I don't think his mode naturally is to stand in there and get sometimes hand-to-hand combat in or just trying to hold the spot.
By the way, that foul on Watts, his fourth. So his light is almost out.
It's not like the Krispy Kreme donut light that's on and everybody's lined up.
Yeah.
One of the things about Nash, he's a little light in the tail. You know, when I was recruiting post players, somebody like him, I'd make more of a four-man. A true five-man has got to have a little caboose on him to hold his spot.
So big thighs.
Well, you look at Johnson. You look at his body makeup. He can hold a spot.
And I think Lawson really likes to go outside, doesn't he? I mean, he's from England. He really enjoys playing more four. And there's a lot of guys. Like, look at Nowitzki. He's that height, and he likes to play outside.
Well, you just said it, Dave, the European flavor, even the big, powerful players, they scoot around on the court. They're very mobile. They handle the ball and cut. I was surprised the international kids I had, how quickly they'd pass and cut. Because usually the big kids in the United States, you know, they hold it and kind of plod around a little bit.
In and out, no good. And again, Western Kentucky kind of letting Southern Miss hang around here. They haven't gone for the knockout punch yet. In fact, the second half is 5-3 in favor of the Golden Eagles.
Well, that's where we were talking about the gut-wrenching thing about being up 15. You know, if you were up 12, 13, 14, 15, and you don't extend it, eventually the other team's going to go, well, I guess they're going to let us back in this thing, and then you got a problem.
So that's why you guys got nervous with a big lead. With the shot clock expiring, that's a two-pointer for Kelgen Blevins.
It becomes a Mailox moment when you all of a sudden are up double digits and you look up and you got to call a timeout, which you don't want to do when you're only up five.
Quick double team on Johnson everywhere he goes. And that's a travel. Boy, don't look now, but Western Kentucky is allowing Southern Miss to climb their way and claw their way back in it. So the Golden Eagles, they were down 15 at the half. Look at it now. It's down to 11. We welcome you back to Diddle Arena in Bowling Green, Kentucky. An 11-point lead right now, but it's dwindling for the Hilltoppers. Well, speaking of scores, how about scores from around Conference USA? As you call it, moving day. And Louisiana Tech in a last-second shot seen here on ASN. They beat Marshall 97-94. How exciting was that game?
Wow, and that game is so pivotal. If you look at the Old Dominion winning, and I'm not saying this just because I used to coach there, there's five teams that have a chance at those four double byes, and Marshall holds the tiebreaker over Old Dominion, having beating them head-to-head on a buzzer beater just like that, similar score, buzzer beater by James Kelly. And so Marshall holds the tiebreaker, so Louisiana Tech, I mean, we're going to come down to Saturday.
Yeah.
It might be moving day, but we're not going to know until the end of Saturday who the top four are.
Until the end of Saturday. So Old Dominion wins. Charlotte wins. How good a job has Coach Mark Davis done there with Charlotte? And then Middle Tennessee, they're also a victor over Florida Atlantic. Looks like Florida Atlantic and UTSA are going to be in that play-in game on Tuesday night. And at first round, second round, third rounds of the Conference USA tournament right here on the American Sports Network. So we look at the standings in Conference USA, and UAB, again, they've wrapped it up. They're the number one seed and the host school. Game tournament will be played in Birmingham. And look at the tie between Middle and Louisiana Tech for second. By the way, Middle Tennessee will be at FIU on Saturday. Marshall now in a tie with Old Dominion for fourth place, as you mentioned.
Well, you've got Marshall and Old Dominion, a win-lose situation where somebody could get fourth, but then Louisiana Tech, a win-lose, there could be a tie there also.
Yeah.
So those
Stay
three
tuned.
Teams, yeah.
It'll be more moving on Saturday.
As Paul Harvey would say, now you don't know the rest of the story. That's why it's moving day. It's not finished yet.
Foul there on Alex Rostow.
You know, you look at the stat sheet, they're down 10 on the glass. They're shooting 50% in the second half, Southern misses.
Yeah.
And Western Kentucky's just come up absolutely dry in the second half. So talk about a land of opportunity for Southern Miss.
0 for 4 for Western Kentucky in the second half. Little fadeaway that doesn't go. Oh, good ball fake. And he got Lawson off his feet.
He faked his shoulders, his hands, the ball, his eyebrows, his hair, everything.
So Tim Rowe will go to the line. Interesting, you have Tim Rowe and you have Kari Price. So it could be T. Rowe Price, right? All on the same team.
You used to work for an advertising agency? You used to sell signage?
Did right,
you,
right.
Or did you sell, like, deluxe checks or something?
Oh, yeah. Well, back in the heyday.
Back in the heyday. Back in your formative years. Think of the jobs we had when we were kids.
Oh, my goodness.
I worked for
you had a paper route, right?
Oh, yeah. Everybody,
everybody had a paper route.
We never admitted it.
No, I admitted it. I was proud of it. I had that until I was 42. No, I'm just kidding. Not that long.
Well, there's been some people waiting for the papers that long.
That was good. That was really good. Oh. I might have peaked as a paper boy in my career.
You peaked?
Yeah, I peaked. That was a peak.
That's tough. That's hard on you.
Tough act to follow that. Yeah, another missed shot. Now 0 for 5, the Hilltoppers. What's going on here?
They can't hit their butt with either hand. I mean, they've had some decent looks. Single digits on a bucket.
Roll, that pass got through.
How? I don't know.
I don't either.
Clock.
Shot clock at 7. Price. Oh, nice move.
Well, as we said, the first half, they're really dependent upon him. I mean, he's like a quarterback at the line trying to say, Omaha, 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 and figure something out at the last second. And he did it.
Doc Sadler, I think, got their attention. 7 straight points by Southern Miss. And how about this, Coach? Only 1 3-point shot in the second half for Southern Miss. There's a big three-pointer by Nigel Snipes to get them off the schneid in the second half.
Well, I think what Southern Miss does is it's like a sleep aid. They just put you to sleep, and pretty soon you're in a close game. But Snipe had an answer for that. He sniped out a three-pointer big fashion. That was well off the line, too. It wasn't that open.
Trying to pass it inside, and a holding call on Rosto.
Well, it must be the right call because Rowe couldn't even go for the ball. I mean, he wasn't even able to go sideways, much less airborne. Somebody had a vice grip on him.
Well, you can see here what Rowe's trying to do is he gets Rosto on his hip, who's fronting him. He's trying to push him up the paint to get more space on the back end.
Yeah, he's kind of trying to clear space.
Ooh. And a good inbounds play that allows Jackson to get free.
That 4 on the baseline action you saw there, they worked on that a bunch today at shoot-around, and you saw the interior opportunities potentially, and there they got one.
And this is where you need your leaders like Johnson to come along.
And look at all the post-doubles. I mean, everybody, it's not NBA rules. There's a lot of guys in the paint ready to go get Johnson. Look at that.
Boy, he draws a crowd. Hunter. Tough little shot in the paint.
Not an easy left. You know, it's funny, they can't make a shot. And they got a whole bunch of good ones. They shoot 2 of the hardest shots of the day.
Yeah.
Like Buddy Hield, just, you know, they just think they're going to make it, and they did. Boy, he shoots some hard shots.
Is he going to be player of the year?
I don't know how he can't be. I mean, there's some other guys having good years, but he's been phenomenal.
And they say Valentine's got a good shot for Michigan State. Jackson with a 3-pointer.
If Valentine had been healthy all year,
yeah,
I think that would be quite a discussion. The fact that he, you know, while he was out, that's when Heald took Oklahoma to number 1 for a while. And then you got a target that's just, you know, as big as a garage door, that bullseye. Look at how quickly they doubled him and took the ball out of his hands.
Oh, good pass. Good find inside, and Jackson came over late.
He just threw a bullet in there for a little bullseye.
Remember when there were only 5 team fouls on Western in that first half? They already have 6 in the second half, so that puts Southern Miss in the bonus.
They could play upon that if they attacked more,
yeah,
but that's really not their style.
Snipes. Well, he's the one that got him going, and 2 threes for Snipes.
Can you believe it? No way. I mean, all the good shots they've had, and then all of a sudden they make 3 of the hardest shots, 2 3-pointers about 24 feet out. The interior shot right into pressure. So, I mean, they earned this lead back.
Well, a little snipe hunting by Nigel. as he hits yet another three, and it's back to a comfortable lead for the Hilltoppers. Welcome back to Diddle Arena with Blaine Taylor. I'm Dave Armstrong. And, Coach, if I can brag on you just a little bit, I want to show the folks at home some of your hard-earned work as a head coach in college basketball. Look at all the hardware that you've collected throughout your career. Well, did you know that? Did you know you had that many rings?
Well, that kind of adds up, doesn't it? Boy, it just, you reflect on all the good players and things, but you know, the thing that is interesting about it is as you come into tournament time right now is a team like Western Kentucky, you're just like, I don't want to play somebody that's playing that good, hasn't won a lot, because your fans don't know. I mean, you hope your players know what you're up against. And then in this day and age, many of those rings, you used to have eight teams in the league, and you get, you know, had seven of them, you're in first. Now you get ahead of seven, you're in fifth or seventh. So yep. Winning a 10, 12, 14 team league is even tougher now. So those championships are gold, and there's a lot that goes into it.
That's pretty special. 10 rings that I counted there. By the way, inside they go to Tim Rowe. So some points in the paint. You can tell that Doc Sadler said, all right, guys, we're not just going to live outside in the three. I don't mind a three. We can't just live out there. And then Justin Johnson knifes his way into the paint.
You know, I don't wear a lot of those rings, but these kids love it. And yeah. I'll tell you what, you want to motivate guys before tournament time, have them put on a ring sizer.
Oh, yeah.
Show them some pictures.
Well, you have them sized for your thumb, then you have one for the thumb, one for each thumb.
Actually, some of them are so big you can't. But these kids like them so big,
right.
I can't even wear them out in public. But, yeah, they would fit on my thumb.
Yeah. So we got another timeout. 10:19 remaining. And the Hilltoppers continue to keep Doc Sadler's Golden Eagles at arm's length. a 13-point lead now. There for a while, the Hilltoppers were letting it slip away, but then Snipes came in, hit a couple of big threes. Justin Johnson did, and that makes Coach Harper just a little bit more comfortable sitting over there on the sideline.
Yeah, he can put that mailbox back away for a moment, but, you know, give credit where credit's due. Southern Miss comes out and shoots 58% from the floor to get back at it.
Yep.
And then all of a sudden, Western Kentucky, they're just in a drought. And now they've bounced back up and made their last five shots.
Yeah, well, that free throw was not one of them.
That was a UFO.
And he missed them both. Cosby grabs that rebound.
Well, he worked so hard to earn those throws and empty. You can hear the shoes squeaking. They're trying.
Rostov doubled. Swing the ball to the other side. It's stuck there, though. Shot clock at one. Nope. Shot clock violation.
Well, they're moving the ball, but nobody has the inclination to shoot or drive, and they got the ball to the post touch. But these post doubles are causing them concern, and when you do it too late in the clock, you can't counter.
How do you counter that? I mean, when they double a post like that, what do? You got to have a guy drive in the lane, don't you?
Well, you try to dive because you know, they've only got three guys to guard four. But somebody dives, and then I would put a guy on what I call the garden spot on the backside elbow. So you want to try to get to where the defense isn't, you know, kind of in really non-commonsensical, let's go where they ain't.
Right. And the shot clock at one. Rowe, he didn't get it off in time. That's two possessions in a row that are empty.
I had a team that led the nation in rebounding in 2011. And one of the things we would do out of that is, guys, just get it up on the glass. There's no blockout angles. Even if you're in the double team, just get it up on the glass and we'll go get it. So let's get the ball up before they can block us off. And if we don't put it in, we're going to put it back in.
Sometimes that's really good offense. Just get it up on the glass and we'll go get it.
As long as everybody's anticipating it and you got the right personnel.
A wide open look for Cosby.
Now they've got a little more swagger right now. They're at home, their last weekend. Got senior day coming on Saturday. It's senior weekend all the way around. And they've got three fifth-year seniors.
Cosby having a good night, 5 for 9 from three-point range, and Rowe misses a bunny.
Well, he's got the bunny. He missed the two free throws, so he's had a potential 6 points. He's got 1 point to show for it.
Well, just a freshman, Rowe. He's going to learn. One big giant step in there around Rowe.
Three small steps for me, one giant step for Rowe.
Well, you're quoting my Uncle Neil. 7 straight points now by the Hilltoppers.
Well, you got to outdo me just because my relative started the school.
That's
here.
Right. Yeah, my guy was the first one on the moon. No, yeah, he's not related. I wish he were.
Well, maybe you'll get some royalties, or maybe somebody, maybe he owes some Super Bowl bets. People will find you. You know, Crosby is an interesting cat. I mean, he had 8 three-pointers in one game, 5 in a couple, 6 in another. I mean, when they get heated up, they're really potent offensively.
Shot clock at 4. Cosby.
He must have heard me. Wasn't no 3, though.
Yeah. Quite a run by Western right now, and Ramey can't find the range. How about this? Southern Miss shooting 53% in the second half, and they're falling further behind.
I can't remember the last miss by Western Kentucky.
It's been a while.
They started out, missed their first 5, and made their last 8 in a row.
Yeah. They get 9 in a row.
If they make 10 in a row, our producer will buy them all a new pair of cowboy boots, I bet, huh? The new boots he was wearing today.
Oh,
holy smokes, those things glowed. They were white. Looked like he was going to the prom.
Get him a glass of milk. He's like Pat Boone.
I don't know what skirt he was going to wear with them, but boy, they were nice.
We won't mention names, but his initials are Sean Moore.
Yeah, yeah.
That was a case, too, where if Rostov had better position, that was an easy pass inside. But why do that when you got Cosby hitting three-pointers?
Oh, that's 10. That's 10 in a row. Three boots, Sean Moore.
See you guys in Nashville. 3-pointers for Cosby.
See you at the Boot Barn in Nashville.
He had 8 trays against Eastern Kentucky. Going for the knockout punch here. Another one? Oh. You're surprised now when they missed. They couldn't hit a shot in the first 3 minutes of the half. And now Edmund caps it off with a nice drive on the baseline.
Well, Ray could put the mailboxes away. He can go put it in the fridge. Take it off the bench.
I would think so. And looking to be the first to 72 points. They're almost there. 66 now for Western Kentucky, thanks to the hot shooting of Aaron Cosby with 6 three-pointers tonight.
Yeah, the threes are raining for the Hilltoppers, especially for Aaron Cosby, who has 6 threes tonight. He's 6 for 11, along with 4 rebounds, 22 points for Cosby.
Well, he has the diddle record. He was 8 for 11 on December 1st, as you said, against Eastern Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
But he's had 6 before. He's had 5 a couple of times. But against Eastern Kentucky, he was 8 for 11. Now, you've seen Western Kentucky just made their 10th three-pointer, a lot of it on his shoulders. And when he gets heated up, it seems like it just spreads, you know? It's like a virus that just goes through the team. We just all start making shots.
10 threes for the game, 6 for him. Snipes has hit a couple of big ones in this game. He was the one that really got him going in the second half.
Yeah, good point. They were kind of dead in the water. Yeah. He just jumped up and knocked a couple, and all of a sudden everybody says, oh, that ain't that hard. I can do that, too.
And you get the sense, too, don't you, Coach, that the Golden Eagles are kind of out of gas.
Well, it's been a long season,
yeah.
You know, and I really have the utmost respect for they've hung in here. They've scratched. They've clawed. Day after day, I would look in the standings. I'd look at the scores and go, geez, they had a chance,
yeah.
And they're clawing out some wins, but it's just an uphill battle when they've got such a shadow that hangs over top of them with this NCAA situation.
Self-imposed sanctions, and you see Watts is fouled out of this game. One more game remaining this year for the Golden Eagles. That's at Marshall on Saturday. Cosby can't miss right now. That's 7.
Well, you try to keep a team from looking at the finish line, season over, but man, when you're sitting here, the other team's just draining threes. You had senior night last Saturday. You're not going to the tournament.
Yeah.
I mean, they're only human, and you know, as much as their shoes are scratching and they're trying, you've got Western Kentucky has a whole different vibe. They're at home, they're heading to the tournament. You know, they came off a pretty good weekend last weekend with a win at Middle Tennessee. In fact, Cosby had five threes in that game, and Aaron hit the go-ahead three in the last minute. So, you know, they've got a mojo right now that makes them, you know, dangerous going forward.
I agree with you. I think this team is a team that you look at and you go, boy, don't sleep on Western Kentucky. This win here tonight will make them 7-10 in conference play, and they just keep moving up. They've got a good chance to be the eighth or ninth seed, and they could make some noise next week in Birmingham.
Now, when I said 72 was the number that they had to get to, I think we're safe. I think the amazing Kreskin is alive and well.
You're going to go home tonight and go, I told those guys 72 was the magic number.
72, they had to get there. They got there.
It could have been 62.
Could have been 82 maybe. No, if you looked at the numbers, they're averaged 76, and you're looking at Southern Miss. They don't give up a lot of points, so there was something had to give. They were going to either score some points, and now they've made 11 three-pointers. You know, I mean, that's 33 points. All bets are off. You know, somebody that's been a silent hero, the assist-to-turnover ratio is 2-1, and McNeil has 5 assists, no turnovers.
Yeah. He's not going to score a lot for you, but if he can just be that distributor with very few turnovers, I mean, that he could be have a huge role here in his freshman year.
As just a freshman, as you say. So sometimes freshmen come of age late in the year. They're not freshmen anymore. They've played, you know, 25, 30 games. And so as they go forward, to have that trigger man, you know, distributing the ball sure helps.
He needs just 4 more assists this year to be the all-time leader as a freshman for most assists in a season.
Gotta love that.
Welcome back to Diddle Arena in Bowling Green, Kentucky. When you look at Conference USA coming up next week, and we're looking forward to that. We look at the if the season were to end today, and again, Saturday is going to be a big moving day. But if it were to end right now, Florida Atlantic and UTSA in that play-in game, and again, that's on ASN. And then you have Rice and FIU, Old Dominion, and the winner of the Florida Atlantic UTSA game, UTEP against Western Kentucky, Charlotte against North Texas, the top 4 seeds. And that's going to stay, I think, the same. It'll be UAB, Marshall, Louisiana Tech, Middle Tennessee. Those teams, though, could juggle a little bit. Not UAB, but the other three could juggle.
They could juggle. Old Dominion still got a chance there. So three of those 4. Now, I look at it, and I look at where the semifinal matchups would be and go, wow, what games that would be. Somebody in round 2 is going to get beat. One or two of those top seeds will get beat. So there's going to be a lot of excitement there. In these tournaments, my favorite day is the semifinals. Championship to championship, but man, those are usually 2 great games.
You start using clock a little bit now if you're Western.
Yeah, you know, your last home weekend, you might let them go a little bit. You're going to be respectful of the opponent. So you'll just play smart. You might take something early, but in a normal situation, you'll probably pass it a few times. You can manipulate that by what you call.
Well, Campbell comes in with his third three of the game.
He's just jumped up and buried him a few times.
That's eight threes now for the Golden Eagles.
Well, at halftime, they each had six. Mm-hmm. Had we not had that bad sequence, I think Southern Miss would have got to the locker room just down, you know, 3, 4, 5 points.
As it was, they were down 15, and Western let them get back inside of 10 in the second half, and then the Hilltoppers just put it away.
To your point, they ran a lot of time there, ended up with a turnover, so yep. There was a lot of pace to that.
And a three-pointer rings home for Robert Thomas III.
Well, that's what they've done all year. They just don't go away completely. You got to give Western Kentucky some credit. I thought they were right for the pick in there at the start of the second half, and boy, they came alive.
I think some of this, too, is about building momentum for next week. And they've got a big game against Louisiana Tech right here at Diddle Arena on Saturday.
That's a huge game, I mean, yeah. For both teams. Yeah. I mean, I think that the little bit of momentum that Western Kentucky Senior Day tries to take to the tournament, but Louisiana Tech, you know, coming off the big win today, if they could finish that off and take their own momentum in, that would be big.
And I don't think there's enough separation between the teams that are in first, second, third, fourth, and those teams that are in seventh, eighth, ninth, and tenth in this league.
You know, you talk to somebody in the league office, and there's two four-letter words. They don't like separation because they want parity, and they don't want parity because they want separation. Because the country wants to see separation because they want you to say, you got some really good teams at the top. But everybody wants parity because everybody can beat everybody. Mm-hmm. And you can't have it both ways, and yet you're always mad no matter which way it is.
Huh. No foul called here on Quentin Campbell.
Here's an example, the West Coast Conference. Everybody always used to say, well, Gonzaga's the only good team. So there's always a separation. So how good is the league? Now you got BYU, St. Mary's, and Gonzaga. There's a good chance that only the tournament champion will go to the NCAAs. They've got parity, no separation. It's not going to lead to more bids right now.
Now coming up Saturday on the American Sports Network, I'll be at Florida Atlantic as they take on UAB. And then Old Dominion against Rice. All that coming up here on ASN on Saturday.
I did the Rice game at Old Dominion where Rice came in and just shocked everybody and won. So that rematch will be interesting. Mm-hmm. Freshman of the year for sure, Marcus Evans. Five consecutive freshman of the years, yeah. Nine total. He had a huge game there, and he's from that area, from Chesapeake right there near Old Dominion.
Yeah, that's lock. I think coach of the year, player of the year, still kind of up for grabs. And it's tough to really lock down on any one person or one coach.
Well, the coaches, you know, that's always a kind of a fickle award. Mm-hmm. A lot of petty things go into that, so I don't know if I'll touch on that. But sometimes, you know, you have somebody that wins the league like you were talking about, Jared Haas. I mean, they don't really have a whole bunch of guys player of the week, but they're winning the league going away, so yep. Who knows. But you know, player of the year, you've got four different kids that have been player of the week three times. How do people see, you know, UAB winning it? How people see those four kids? You know, will be interesting. I think that they vote tomorrow, we were told.
Yeah.
So Saturday's game is not included in the
not
ballot. So right now, you know, hold those parimutuel wagers because it's in.
Well, I think Jared Haas will be strongly considered for winning the conference and winning it outright. I think D'Antoni's got a good shot because
yeah.
Marshall came from nowhere. And they really made a lot of noise this year. I think what Louisiana Tech has done of late, you know, is going to put them on the map.
Well, Eric is a first-year coach.
Yeah.
Eric Conkle, you know, he's earned the respect. He's earned his chair at the coaches' table in the league meetings. So it'll be interesting. You've got a lot of different guys that could be voted for it. It'll probably be a close vote.
And I think the same could be said for Player of the Year. It's going to be very interesting. Because you're right, no one from UAB has really stood out and said, well, there's the one guy from you. They've had three or four guys that have been really good for them that allowed the Blazers to win the league outright.
I'll bet you they'll split votes, and so they won't have a winner, and I bet you that Jared would have a hard time telling you there's one guy to vote for.
Yeah. Well, right now, Coach Harper is able to clear his bench. Waters checks out.
Well, they took care of business.
Kiefer Dalton is in. Dylan Sanford is in.
He's just going to burn the clock. I was correct on the 72, but not by much.
And Coach Sadler told his guys to back off.
This is about their season averages, believe it or not. Southern Miss averages 62 points a game. Western Kentucky averages 75 and some change.
I think we're going to have a half second, right, once they dribble out this possession. Yep, about 0.6.
I had this happen one time, and the about that much differential, and the guy just threw it up in the air, and it swished. And the other coach looked at me like, you dirty. I go, man, yeah,
And that's the way this game comes to a close. Good win for Western Kentucky.
Sure is. I mean, Doc Sadler's, they're coming to the end of the trail, but Western Kentucky, they're starting to move down the trail in pretty good fashion.
Well, no question about it. Really good win for the Hilltoppers here. And they're able to get to 15-15 overall and 7-10 in conference play. So you look at Western Kentucky, and again, a team that has had so many close losses this year. If they can put together a little string, they could make some noise next week in Birmingham.
What jumps out at me is 10 different guys scored. Cosby has a big night, and they did it without Justin Johnson going crazy. So they got some pieces healthy right now.
So that's the end of the show here in Western Kentucky. And from Diddle Arena, we say so long. The Hilltoppers win this one by the final score of 75-60. For Blaine Taylor and our entire crew, I'm Dave Armstrong. Thanks for watching tonight on the American Sports Network. And we bid you a good night from Bowling Green. Monica and Jorge in the ASN studio after the break.
Whatever you want to do.